So today, we'll start with our client information management 101. Okay, we're starting with filling out of student enrollment form. So we have our enrollment form here from one of the colleges we are working with and their courses and programs. All right, so today I will show you how to fill in the student enrollment form correctly.
Yeah.
We need this student enrollment form to enroll the student to the colleges or university for us to be able to get a certificate of enrollment that is required by the immigration department in applying for student visa.
Okay.
I will explain to you, as I said before, explaining to you why and how to apply, fill in the form. Also, I will demonstrate how to do it. And after that, one of you has to do it for me.
Who would that be?
Oh, no.
And then I will be giving a feedback. And after that, we will have the recap of the concept about information gathering, efficiency, and
process
streamline. Okay. In this enrollment form, the first question is the course. So we need to know and ask the student what course they're applying for. Okay. And then if, of course, this time it says here agent information. So we are agent, we are student agents, so we have to tick yes. Of course, for us to get the commission. And then we have to put the name of the agent or company and the name of the contact person. And then comes the personal details. I would advise you would ask them for their passport to get their correct personal details. Also, we need their residential address. We have to inform the department of their address, and if they will move to another place, then we have to inform them of the changes. Okay, we also need the student contact. We need their phone number and email address. Number 7, emergency contact. This is very important for students that are underage. So we need the name of their guardian here and the phone number. Next page. We need also their schooling, their prior schooling. If they finish, what level they finish, if they finish secondary school, primary school, or anything that they finish. And also, we also need their previous qualification, like bachelor, advanced diploma, or any certificate they need. We need this to pre-qualify the student. So if they already did the certificate 2, 3, and 4, for example, our student now would like to study diploma in hospitality. For him not to repeat the other courses, we need this information.
Uh-huh,
okay? Uh-huh. Now, we also need, if they did work before in their country, home country, we also need the information about that and the the reason for study. On the last page, they have to sign the form, print out their name, and put the date.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Okay.
Yeah.
Now, I will ask Ms. Pavan to fill in the form, and afterwards I will check it.
Yeah, before you fill the form, I have a question. So where do we get the list of courses from the brochure?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Almost
so
all the colleges
that
have these courses and programs.
Mm. And the exact title there should be the one in the
yes.
Form.
Yes. So you should indicate here or write down the course's name.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Can I have the brochure? I want to study commercial cookery. So I will go here. So can I do the diploma as well?
You are the learner, you are not the student.
You're the agent.
Yeah.
Certificate 2,
uh-huh.
3, and. Full time. What RPL means?
Recognition of prior learning. But because you did not, you are not applying for that. You are applying for student visa, so you have to write there full time.
Okay.
Oh, okay. For the residential, is it gonna be, if it's a student outside Australia, can they, should they put their address in their country?
No, they have to put their address here.
Their, oh, okay.
So the department would know where they have to find them.
Mm-hmm.
If they will not comply with the visa condition.
Mm.
For the question about reason for study, then pick one or
is it could be many, yeah, yeah. But there's so many tick boxes.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, they could tick as many as they want.
And if they tick more than one, should we ask more questions at that
we
stage?
Have to, I think we need as much as information we could get from them, because later on we have to prepare, help them prepare the GTE.
So should we, so when they fill that, when they tick that, should we at that stage ask them more about the reason for studying or leave it for that, at that
just
stage?
Leave it, because this is only for the school.
I see.
The other information is for us and for the immigration department.
Mm-hmm.
So
that's when it goes to the agent.
Yes,
and then, yeah,
yes.
The visa.
This has nothing to do with our process.
Okay.
Okay, let me have a look at this.
Wow.
Okay.
How does it feel? How does it feel? Yeah.
Certificate
okay.
3.
At least I remember my own.
Okay. So you wrote here starting month. Yeah, we have to put that. Because we also have to calculate their health cover. And then the agent information. Yeah, for us to get the commission from the school. The name, the gender,
yeah.
Address, correct. Student contact, you forgot to put the emergency contact.
Oh. That's really important because it's emergency. For emergency purposes.
I don't remember.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, this is correct. Correct. Alright. And you forgot to put the date, so please put the date.
Yeah.
What's the date?
Wonderful.
Okay. Now, why are we filling in this form? before to get the information regarding the student, and also this information are needed by the school.
Yeah.
And what they needed to inform the Department of Education about the students' personal details. And that will also facilitate the enrollment of the student.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? Yeah. So we are done for today. Do you have any question? Did you understand?
Yep.
Yeah, yeah, it's pretty clear.
Do you think you can do it alone?
Yep.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. Mm-hmm. So be prepared. We will have an assessment tomorrow.
Okay.
And see what the result will be.
All
right.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.